Yase.
Do you want to be a winner?
Yeah!
Then sound your buzzer! Sound your bell! And let's play Winner Take All with our Winner Take All Quizmaster, Bill Collins!
Thank you. Thank you, everybody. Thank you, Don Pardo. Welcome back. Welcome back, everybody, to Winner Take All. Gee, this is our third day in our new time. You can see us now as well as hear us, and I want to say we're terribly happy to be here. And we're also happy to have back with us today our champion. If you recall, yesterday, as time was called, a brand new champion took her place on Winner Take All. As a matter of fact, we didn't have a chance to give her any prizes yet. Right now, I'd like you to meet the lady. It's Dr. Tillman. Dr. Tillman, welcome back to Winner Take All. Well, we're awfully happy to have you. Would you tell everyone where you're from again, Dr. Tillman?
Grand Rapids, Michigan.
Grand Rapids, Michigan, and you're a chiropractic...
I am a chiropractor, yes.
And what was that you said that your husband had when he first came to see you? He came as a patient, by the way. What was it he had?
An acute sacroiliac slip.
What's he have now?
Well, I hope
you.
He has nothing, just me.
imagine a lady meeting a man for the first time and he has an acute sacroiliac slip. Oh, for heaven's sake. Not even coats like the rest of us. Dr. Tillman, yesterday, as I say, I certainly didn't want to run away on you like we did because time caught up with us. You probably want to know what you won, don't you?
I certainly would like to.
Well, I certainly want to tell you. I certainly want you to find out about that. We're going to get back and explain the game in a moment. But first, Don Pardo, suppose you tell Dr. Tillman what she's in for.
Right, Bill. And Dr. Miriam Tillman, your prize was worth waiting for. From Prom Home Permanent, the wonderful new home permanent that needs no neutralizer as Prom neutralizes automatically, a generous supply of Prom Home Permanent, and $250 in United States defense bonds. Congratulations! Take all!
Say,
that's worth waiting for.
Isn't that worth waiting for? That surprised me. You got Prom permanence for straightening out sacroiliac slips and for making curly hair that isn't curly. And what, $250?
That's right.
Oh, for goodness, what are you going to do with that?
Well, I'm going to save it.
You're
going to
say, you wouldn't mind
that's
lending me about 50, would you?
Be happy to.
Because it's a new show and I haven't been paid yet, you know.
I say, when I get it, I'll let you have it.
All right, I'm saving to buy some makeup. I'll tell you what, Dr. Tillman, we want you, before we do another thing, we want you to meet your first challenger. Marion, would you bring the first lady over? There's a lady, and I'm lucky there. How do you do?
I do.
Marion, who's this?
Bill, I'd like you to meet Mrs. Elaine Heller.
Hello, Elaine Heller.
I do.
Awfully happy to have you see. Let me see. It says you're from Atlanta. Is that right?
I sure am.
You what?
I sure am.
You sure am? Well, I sure am, too. I mean,
I
think might as well both sure am. How long have you been married, Miss Heller?
17 years.
Oh, for goodness sake. Any children?
I have two, a girl and a boy.
That's a nice way to break it up, I say. What are you doing in New York, ma'am?
Well, my husband's in the pipe business, and he's trying to get connected.
Isn't he, he came to New York to get connected?
Yes.
He's not connected in Atlanta,
well,
in other words.
Well, he is pretty good, but he wants to get a better connection.
He wants a better connection, so he came to New York. What would he like to do? I mean, where would he like to connect? Let's put it that way.
Well, his brother's connected with gas, and he'd like to get to New York. I mean, with natural gas and that sort of area.
His brother's connected with gas, and he'd like to get connected
with gas.
Sounds pretty uncomfortable to me. I'll tell you what, if he gets the job and his brother's connected with gas and he's connected with... That's the most connected family, isn't it?
Well, we try to be.
This fellow and his brother can cook on the double burner, you know, unless they're awfully careful. What did you do before you were married?
I
Where were you
connected with a bank. Well, I don't know.
You were connected with a bank?
Yes.
Didn't you find it difficult getting along with his bank on your back all the time?
Well, you see, I met this woman out at the federal prison. We were...
You met... Where was she connected?
Well, we were just visiting out of...
This lady, what was this lady's name? What was her number?
Miss Hobbs. Oh, she didn't have a number.
Was that before or after you worked in the bank?
Well, that was after.
And this lady was just visiting the prison?
Yes, yeah, she had helped me get the job out.
Oh, I see. What were you doing at the prison?
I was showing my husband around.
He was connected to a chair out there,
well,
you
no,
know?
He...
Yeah? Well, what was he doing out there?
Well, he's a Yankee, and I've been showing him all those different sites.
Hey, where was this prison?
No, it's out right outside of Atlanta.
Here's a Yankee, goes to the South, goes to Atlanta. The first thing they do is show him the prison. And then they connected him. I'll tell you what, I want to get into this a little more fully, but first, before I get too badly connected, would you kindly go over there and meet Dr. Tillman, Mrs. Heller?
I'm glad to.
I'll connect you with her.
Hello.
Dr. Tillman, this is number 3151742. one of the best connected kids we've ever had on the show. All right, now, get ready. Oh, but I got to explain real fast. Winner take all, you all know, works with a bell and buzzer. Dr. Tillman, your bell, please. And Mrs. Heller, your buzzer. I won't ask any more questions. You, here comes your first question. Tie score, of course, because there's no score at all. Get ready. Here we go. Now, remember, as soon as you think you know the answer, sound that signal. What popular comedian has created the character of Clem Kadiddlehofer? There's the bell. What do you say, Dr. Tillman? Quickly. Oh, I have to call time on you. It's Red Skelton. Red Skelton, who does the mean little boy in Clem Kadiddlehofer. You had it there until you went to say it. Well, I'll tell you, winner take all, you have to answer real quickly, because once you sign your bell, see, the challenger doesn't get much of a chance. So now, Mrs. Heller, we have a connecting question for you. I think you'll like this. Here we go. This is all yours. You don't even have to use your buzzer on this. What people were the first people we know of to dance the fandango? Think that out. I mean, what race of person would you say were the first race of people?
Mexican.
That was pretty close, but it wasn't quite at the Spanish, did it? And then, of course, that was taken up in Mexico, same as the language. So, nothing happened there. Score stands 0-0. You're both eligible now. Ready with your signals. Sometimes on the bottom of an invitation, you're going to find the initials RSVP. The buzzer, what do you say?
Respondez,
si vous plaît is right, and you have a point. 1 point for you. Actually, that respondez, s'il vous plaît, is French, and it means write me back or I'll connect you. Here comes the next question. 1-0 for our challenger. Here we go. If you were to finish writing a letter and add the initials SWAK, the buzzer, what do you...
Sealed with a kiss.
Sealed with a kiss is right. You got another point. You must have written a lot of letters in your time. That's all I...
I'd like to write, Bill, but I still haven't written you a fan letter.
You haven't?
I think you deserve
it. Well, I certainly think so. I mean, glad you think so. She's too busy writing to the governor for a pardon. We have 2 points. We have 2 points for our challenger and no points for our doctor. Are you still with us now?
I certainly am.
I'll tell you what you better do. You better give her a separated sacroiliac thing or something like that.
That's better.
All right, now try your bell once. Make sure it's working. Oh, the buzzer, please. All right, now you're both eligible. Here we go. Hang on, ladies. Was Martha Washington the first or the second wife of the buzzer? What do you say?
Second.
Oh, no, she was the first. In fact, she was...
she was married before.
Yeah, she was married before, but she was his only wife. In fact, she was married twice and later opened a candy shop, as you recall. That's a wrong answer for our challenger. And Dr. Tillman, you get a chance to answer now. Everything...
Wonderful.
All right, now get ready. Let's see what happens. There's a well-known breed of dog, Doctor. There's a well-known breed of dog called the Airedale. Does the Airedale have a soft, silky coat or a stiff, wiry coat?
It has rather of a wiry, curled coat.
Yes, you have a point. Now it's 2-1. Sure. I'm a little interested to know. I mean, you got that so well. You described the Airedale's coat so well. What does your husband do again, Dr. Tillman?
He is a furrier, but I have a boxer dog, and an Airedale comes over to play with my Ingeborg occasionally.
A boxer comes over to play with your Airedale?
No, I have a boxer, and the Airedale comes over to play with my boxer.
With your boxer.
Mm-hmm.
Would you say that your husband has saved over the years being married to a chiropractor? Would you say he saved much in chiropractic fees? I mean, because he had this sacroiliac.
Well, yes, he might, because he did have an injury in service.
About how much would you say he saved?
Well, at least $3 each time you need treatment.
And how many times would that be?
That would be hard to say over a period of 4 years.
I was trying to figure, have you saved anything on fur coats?
I certainly have.
All right, I just want to check up on that. Now, you know, someday that Airedale's not going to go back home. I can see that Airedale. All right, get ready now. It's 2 for the challenger, 1 for the champion. Here we go. Only one of our states starts with a letter U.
Utah.
The bell is first. What do you say?
Utah.
Yes, ma'am. You've got a point. It's all tied up at 2-3. Yes, ma'am. The letter U starts Utah, spelled U-T-A-H. Now we have 2 points for Dr. Tillman, 2 points for Mrs. Heller, and we got ourselves a real tie score. Now, ladies, relax, because this is the all... Relax if you can. This is the all-important point coming up. This one is going to do it. So let's see who gets it first and wins the round. Get ready, both of you. Here we go. In what occupation or profession has gorgeous George become... The bell is first again. The bell goes...
Wrestling
is right, and the bell was first, and you're still champion. I want to get all the congratulations. Congratulations to you. ever so much, Dr. Tillman. And thank you, Mrs. Heller, for being with us. You were a swell sport, a real swell sport. And I think the audience appreciated the way we had all this fun. And better luck to you next time on Winner Take All. And as far as you're concerned, Dr. Tillman, you've already won a prom, $250. Now you have something else coming, right?
Right.
All right, we're not going to keep you waiting anymore. Here's Don Pardo to tell you just what you've won.
All right, Bill, and Dr. Miriam Tillman, from the Admiral Corporation, an Admiral refrigerator with flash defrosting, the fastest and most economical automatic defrosting, where you press a button and frost is gone in 7 minutes. That's an Admiral refrigerator, and it's all yours, Dr. Tillman, with congratulations from Winner Take All.
Wonderful. Thank you so much.
Wow.
Wonderful.
An Admiral refrigerator, huh?
That sounds marvelous.
Boy, and all you want to take all this back to Atlanta with you, or send it all back to Atlanta, I imagine.
No, I'm from Grand Rapids.
Oh, Grand Rapids.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, it's Mrs. Heller's from Atlanta.
Yes.
Right after she got out of the bank.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. All right. We want you, now that you've won, this is your second consecutive round,
okay.
We want you to meet your new opponent. Now, suppose Marion brings your opponent out right now. Marion? Well, say, this isn't a lady. How do you do, sir?
Glad to know you.
Marion, who is this distinguished gentleman here?
I'd like to meet Mr. Frank McGee.
Mr. McGee, welcome to Winner Take All.
Thank you.
We're awfully happy to... Where are you from, Mr. McGee?
Hampton Bays, Long Island.
What do you do out there?
Well, I'm a retired country gentleman now.
Yeah?
Spend my time gardening and farming.
What'd you do before that?
Well, I'm a retired chief engineer of the city of New York and also a retired baseball player and umpire where I spent 43 years.
You spent 43 years being a baseball umpire?
Between pitching and umpiring.
Pitching, umpiring, and chief engineer in New York?
Yes.
How'd you find time to do all that, Mr. McGee?
Well, I used to do that on holidays, Saturdays, Sundays, and nights.
Holidays? That doesn't leave much, does it?
No, sir. I didn't have much time to myself between working and playing ball and umpiring during all these years.
You were kept pretty busy. Do you have any amusing stories? Anything happened to you while you were umpiring?
Well, one of the most amusing stories I had occurred and when I was umpiring a game at the Suffolk County Fair.
Mm-hmm.
I was behind the plate with all my chest protector and mask. And a friend of mine come up to me and he says, hello, Frank. Here's a nice big red apple for you.
This fellow said, you're in a ball game?
Yes, yeah. I was right behind the plate umpiring, calling balls and strikes.
Yeah.
So I put the apple in my pocket, not thinking. You know, we carry baseballs, and umpires carry baseballs in the pocket.
Always have their pocket full of baseballs,
I went out a couple of innings, never thought a thing.
Yeah.
First thing you know, a foul ball or something happened that they needed a baseball. I just threw it out.
Threw it out.
Happened to be the apple.
Happened to be the apple?
Yes.
That's all right. That must have gotten you quite a reputation, huh? I'll tell you what, Mr. McGee, we want to hear more about this baseball thing, but you threw the apple out there, and while the person who caught it is bringing it back, I wonder if you'd go over there and say hello to Dr. Tillman. I know you're in good health and all that, but that's Dr. Tillman. Dr. Tillman, Mr. McGee. Mr. McGee, will you take your place up there? And you play sort of first base, close to the foul line there. And Mr. Tillman, you can be Yogi Berra. Mr. Tillman, Dr. Tillman, I'm sorry, I keep doing that to you. I'll tell you what, now, will you try the buzzer, please, Mr. McGee, sir? Mr. McGee and Dr. Tillman, that's right. You got three in there on
that's three strikes.
All right, three. would you try the bell, please, ma'am? Are the rules the same in baseball as they always have been, Mr. McGee?
No, before 1888,
yeah.
I had an indicator.
Yeah.
That had four strikes and five balls.
Yeah.
That was used before 1888.
Uh-huh.
In 1888, the rule was changed.
Yeah.
To three strikes and four balls.
Four balls, yeah.
Yeah, that was okay. And I used that indicator all through my career.
Uh-huh.
And I gave that indicator to Red Barber.
Yeah.
That announces the ball games for the Dodgers.
Yeah.
And that indicator today is in the Hall of Fame, Cooperstown, New York.
Cooperstown, New York, that's where the indicator is.
Yes.
I'll tell you what, that is a pretty interesting story. As a matter of fact, I want to get back there and ask you more about that indicator. It's pretty good to have owned something originally that's now in the Hall of Fame, and I think you have something to be real proud of. But right now, what we want to do is pause ever so briefly. We're going to be back to Winner Take All in just a second with Mr. McGee and Dr. Tillman. But first, here's a pause for station identification.
I'd like to tell you about a clinical research trial which is studying a new investigational drug to treat type 2 diabetes. If you have type 2 diabetes, are not on insulin, the only medication you are taking is glucophage or metformin, and are between the ages of 18 and 70, you may be able to participate in this study. People who qualify and decide to participate in this trial will receive study-related medication, medical care, lab work, diabetic and nutritional counseling, and glucose monitoring supplies, all at no cost. To learn how to participate, please call this number today.
On the series finale of Average Joe Hawaii, it's the ultimate showdown, personality.
I want to show the world that the average regular guy can get the girl.
Versus looks.
I hope she knows I'm very interested in her.
But as her passion grows stronger with two final dream dates.
It just blew me away.
It's a true dream come true.
Will the love of her life be destroyed by her secret?
I do have something in my past.
Average Joe Hawaii, the series finale, Wednesday night at 10 on GSN, the network for games.
Winner take all, and here's your master of ceremonies, Bill Collins.
For the benefit of any of those of you who might just be joining our program, we will say that Dr. Tillman, who had just won when time was called yesterday, has successfully defended that championship of hers. She's now won two in a row. She's gotten $250 from an Admiral refrigerator, and she has just been introduced to a very interesting gentleman who used to be a baseball umpire, Mr. McGee. Mr. McGee, would you move in a little bit closer to Miss... I guess that's close enough. We don't want to get you too...
Wait a minute,
if you're getting closer, we'll have to change the rules, you know.
I don't want to get too close.
How old are you, Mr. McGee? You talked about umpire...
78.
78 years old? Well, boy, you sure look hale and hearty.
Well, it's 78 on Washington's birthday.
I was going to ask how old Dr. Tillman was, but I'm not going to ask that because she's a lady, and boy, ladies don't like to tell their ages. You know that, don't you?
I'm 21.
You're proud of what?
To tell my age.
Oh, I thought you were proud of Dr. Tillman's age.
Well, I am too.
All right, now, we got you two real close together. Now, this round coming up is just a little bit different. We're going to ask, if you will, Mr. McGee, to take your buzzer in your left hand. First of all, we're going to have to do something. First, I'm going to tell you. You know, this is a bottle round. Every day, all of us come in contact with various kinds of bottles. I mean, all kinds of bottles. You know what I mean.
All kinds of bottles?
All kinds of bottles, yeah.
Well, from the time you're a baby up to...
That's right.
Time.
Every day. Yeah. We won't talk about...
That covers a lot of territory.
It sure does. There's a lot of bottles down the... Anyway, I'll tell you what. Now, we're going to ask you to put blindfolds on. Will you be doing that? Mr. McGee, I guess you'll have to take your glasses off. Would you like me to hold them for you?
Right here?
No, I don't think that's safe. I'll tell you, because we're going to use that. You give me those now. Here you are. Will you give me a check for that, please? Pawnbroker back here. I hope they don't either. Put those blindfolds. See those blindfolds down there? Now, you two, just put your bell and buzzer down and get those blindfolds on. Meantime, I'll explain about this game. As we say, we all come in contact with bottles. Now, we're not going to see these bottles because our contestants are going to be all blindfolded, but we're going to give them a chance to feel the bottles. Now, when the blindfolds are on real tight, we're going to bring out some bottles here, but not yet. Would you get your blindfold on, please, Dr. Tillman? Mr. McGee, can you see anything?
Nope.
You're a real baseball umpire now, huh? You're peaking. I tell you. Only blindfold we ever had with bifocals. Go back in there now. All right, goodbye. And Dr. Tillman, can you see anything?
No, I can't.
All right, girls, will you bring out our bit of display here? Here comes the display. Now, don't either of you look now from here on in. Here comes all kind of bottles that our two girls are bringing out. Say, aren't they lovely? And I don't mean the bottles. Now, Dr. Tillman, take your bell in your right hand and put your left hand to your left over there by Mr. McGee's hand. Will you, girls, will you help Mrs. Dr. Tillman get her hand on the pedestal there? There you are. Now, don't hold hands now, please, Mr. McGee. Remember, the baseball season hasn't started. Now, when I say go, the girls are going to put identical bottles into the hands of each of you. We want you, as soon as you can tell what that bottle is by feeling it, we want you immediately to sound your signal and then tell me what it is. Understood? All right, girls, stand by with the first bottle. Ready? Get set. Go. There they go. The bottles go into the hands. They're feeling the bottle now. My goodness, they're massaging the bottles. Your bottle's going to have... There's the bell first. What do you say, Dr. Tillman?
A 7-Up bottle.
7-Up bottle. No, I'm sorry. It is not a 7-Up bottle. It's a Worcestershire sauce. It's a Worcestershire Watts bottle. That's a wrong answer. That's a wrong answer for Dr. Tillman. So a free bottle grasp is coming to Mr. McGee. Would you take Mr. McGee's bottle there, please? The next bottle in line. The next one in line. That's right. And you eliminate yours, please, Marion. And let Mr. McGee feel that bottle. Mr. McGee, here's a bottle for you. Feel it. Now, tell me what it is. This is free. It's all yours. Yes.
Oh, that's a pill bottle
don't shake it. Don't shake the bottle, it'll blow up.
Oh,
no, I'm sorry, it's a bottle of ink, Mr. McGee.
Bottle of ink?
Bottle of ink, yes. Don't take your blindfold off now. Okay, still no score. Get ready, girls, with the bottles. You're both eligible this time. Ready? Get set. Go. See what this one is now, people. Come on, feel all around it there, Mr. McGee. There's the bell. What do you say, Doctor?
A baby bottle.
A baby bottle, Dr. Tillman. That's the right answer. It is a baby bottle. it's a baby bottle. What kind of bottle did you think it was, Mr. McGee?
Well, I didn't know.
All right.
I knew it wasn't the kind I use these days.
No, I... The only thing I have to say, any man who keeps his pills in an ink bottle, you got to watch him. All right, now, both of you get ready. Here comes another one. Ready, girls? Get set. Go. Yes, sir. Feel this bottle good. Now, up and down, Mr. McGee. The girl, hold it for you. Go ahead.
Oh, that's the bell bottle.
No, the bell first. What do you say?
Champagne bottle
is the right answer. Dr. Tillman came up with that. Bottles come awfully big in your neighborhood, Mr. McGee. All right, now, 2-0 in favor of the champion. Get ready again, girls. Ready? Get ready with the bottle. Set. Here it comes. Go. See if you know what kind of bottle this is now. This is a pretty... the bell's
whiskey
first,
bottle.
No, the bell's first. What do you say over there,
whiskey.
Doctor? No, the bell's first, Mr. McGee.
I believe it was syrup bottle.
Syrup bottle is the right answer, and you're still champion. Congratulations. You're going to take off. Okay, girls. Well, the girls are, sir, can I have Mr. McGee's spectacles back, please, just a second? There you are, Mr. McGee, so thank you, sir, for being...
It's a pleasure to meet you.
It was a real pleasure, and you're a grand sport, 78 years old, and you just go right over there for a third base, if you will, Mr. McGee. Thank you, sir. He's all right. I want to say, Mr. McGee, I certainly enjoyed having you with us on the program today, and I know Dr. Tillman had a lot of fun. Hey, you're pretty good in the bottle department, doctor. Gosh,
well.
Huh? You sure know your bottle. Well, we won't go into that. I'll tell you what we're going to do right now. Let me see. You've won all these prizes. Don Pardo, suppose you tell the doctor what else she's won.
And for Dr. Miriam Tillman, a valuable addition to your dining pleasure, 6 complete place settings in lovely Westmoreland solid sterling.
Ooh.
The sterling silver you see at home by appointment. 36 pieces of Westmoreland's permanent pattern, George and Martha. And packed in a beautiful mahogany silver chest from Westmoreland sterling silver. Congratulations from winner take all.
You have really... You're really going great guns there, aren't you, Dr. Tillman?
I certainly am.
Silver, refrigerator, prom, money, wow.
I've never won anything before.
You never won anything?
Oh, maybe a dollar, that's all.
I never won a dollar. I won quarter once, but that was on another show. we want you to meet your next contestant. Marion James, who is it?
Oh, it's a lady. Yes, sir, I hope
you can. How do you do? Whom is this, Marion?
Bill, I'd like you to meet Mrs. Betty Shoup.
Well, I sure would like Mrs.
Right.
Well, I wouldn't like to meet you as much as I would have liked to have met you before I found it was Mrs. Mrs. Shoup?
That's right.
You don't look like a Mrs. Shoup, if you mind my... what was your name before it was Shoup?
It was Trickett.
Don't look much like a Mrs. Trickett, either. I want you to meet my wife, Shoup Knee Trickett. Oh, I'll tell you, probably something could be done by the doctor over there. She's pretty good at trick knees and things like that. Where are you from, Mrs. Shoup?
Memphis, Tennessee.
What are you doing in New York?
My husband is in Germany with the Air Force, and the children are going there to join him.
The children and you.
That's right.
Well, maybe you said the children there for a moment. How long are you going to stay over there?
About 2.5 years.
In other words, you're going to stay over there as long as he's stationed there. Is that right? How long have you been married, Miss Shoup?
9.5 years now.
9.5 years. Mm-hmm. How long has your husband been overseas?
6 months, 10 days, 4 hours, and 13 minutes.
13 minutes.
Either you're a little fast or he left on the half hour. How old are the children?
5 and 2.
Which is the older? I mean, are they both boys or... I got that fine. Are they boys, girls?
They're both boys.
They're both boys, all right. Any funny incidents happen while your husband's been away overseas?
Yes.
With the children?
Lots of funny things.
What?
Well, yes, I think about the funniest thing that happened was about a month ago, the laundryman came to pick up the bundle of laundry and he had on a blue uniform and a blue cap with a bill. And as he picked up the bundle and left, and I closed the living room door, I turned around to see little 2-year-old Larry in a stiff salute. And when I asked him what he was doing, he said, "Salute Daddy."
He was saluting Daddy? Did you, did you take the little boy aside and explain to him that that wasn't Daddy?
Well, I had a rougher time explaining it to my husband.
Yeah. How did he find out? I thought he was in Germany.
Well, at the time, I thought it was a funny little incident, and I wrote him about it.
You wrote him about it?
That's right.
And what did he say?
Well, he wanted to know how often the laundryman came around.
How often does he come around?
About twice a week.
That's all right. A little more. Must be quite a job, though, taking care of two little kids like that with Daddy away, isn't it?
Yes, as a matter of fact, it is. And I really hardly know what to do with all the little animal spirits.
Animal spirits? There's a bottle we didn't have in that contest. Good old animal spirits. What'd you do before you were married?
I was a secretary, and then I was a medical technician in electroencephalography.
In what?
Electroencephalography.
Oh, let's go back to the laundry man. What in the world is electroencephalography?
It's a mouthful.
I know that. Mouthful of what?
It means recording the electrical activity of the brain by means of electrodes.
Oh, would you say I have much electrical activity in my brain from looking at me? I'm connected with gas, I know. When are you going to leave, by the way, to go overseas, Miss Schultz?
Next Saturday.
And where are you going to live in Germany?
Wiesbaden, Germany, in some military quarters.
Well, before we do anything else, I want to wish you the very best of luck on your journey, and I hope you have... We'll go over there and meet Dr. Tillman,
please. Hello.
Mrs. Schultz, this is Dr. Tillman. Say, why don't you two girls talk about electroencephalographs and sacroiliacs? You girls can really talk to each other and no one will know what you're talking about. Mrs. Schultz, will you try your buzzer, please? And your bell, Dr. Tillman. A medical technician and a doctor. Say, here's a question just right for a medical technician and a doctor. It's about art.
Oh, no.
We figured this one out. This all be good. You know, get ready now. The painter Titian, spelled Titian, T-I-T-I-A-N, was noted for his use of a certain color in his works. What color is most associated with him? There's the bell. What do you say,
Doug? Red.
Red is right, Dr. Tillman, and you have the first point lead, 1-0. Yes, ma'am. It didn't tell on the card. I don't know if I'm right or not. I think they call her. There is a color of red named Titian Red.
Yes, there is.
I thought there was. Okay, now one for Dr. Tillman. Nothing for Mrs. Schultz, who's going to Germany. And wouldn't it be swell if you could take a great big 10-cubic-foot refrigerator with you? The shipping company would love that. 1-0 for the champion. Get ready. According to the title of the popular song, life is just a bowl of what? There's the buzzer. What do you say, Mrs. Schultz?
Cherries.
You're right, Mrs. Schultz. You've got a point. It's all tied up. 1 point. Mr. Shoup, 1 point for Dr. Tillman. Life is just a bowl of cherries is the right answer. Tiebreaker, girls, get ready. Let's see who moves out ahead now. If you were to change an English pound into American dollars, would you get more or less than a dollar? There's the bells first. What do you say, Dr. Tillman?
Less.
No, you'd get more. Remember, we asked if you exchanged an English pound for an American dollar.
Oh,
you would get more. It's about $2.40 right now. The dollar, of course, is a dollar. A free question for our challenger over there, Mrs. Shoup, as the arrow indicates. Mrs. Shoup, you get this one all for nothing. Let's see how well you do. Answer it correctly, and you'll have a lead there of 2-1. Here's your question. A popular sports figure has had many nicknames, but the one that by which he's best known, I'm sure, is the Brown Bomber. Don't anybody help. What's his name?
Joe Lewis.
Joe Lewis. I'll say you got that one. You sure did. It is now 2 for our challenger, and it's 1 for our champion. That's a real good game so far. Now, Dr. Tillman's going to try to tie the score, so both of you ladies get ready. Here comes the tie.
On another Dog Eat Dog, the battle to become top dog begins. I'm scared. Dog Eat Dog, weeknights at 9 Eastern and Pacific, only on GSN, the network for games. Hit me with Celebrity Blackjack, Snoop Dogg, Jason Alexander, Andy Dick, Billy Baldwin, Richard Belzer, Jamie Kennedy, Shannon Elizabeth, and many more. Celebrity Blackjack, Mondays at 10 on GSN.
2-1, favor the challenger. You're both eligible now, so come on, get ready. A very commonly used type of window shade should make you think of a famous Italian city. There's the bell. What do you say,
Venetian.
Bella? Venetian or Venice, you're right. It's all tied up at 2 points apiece. Yes, ma'am. Oh, boy. We got ourselves a real rugged round going right now. It's 2 for the champion and 2 for the challenger. And, boy, you girls really have a quote. Relax now. Try the bell, if you will, doctor. Don't work too hard. Try the buzzer, please, ma'am. All right, now, here's a real fast question for a real fast answer. Get ready. The book Gone with the Wind was about a war. What war? There's the bell.
Civil War.
Civil War is absolutely right. You're still champions. Congratulations. Okay. Thank you, Mrs. Schultz. Congratulations, Dr. Tillman. We're going to be back tomorrow at the same time to pick up. And once again, we're starting the day with a prize for you. Congratulations to you, ma'am. And we'll see you tomorrow at the same time. Till then, this is Bill Cullen saying thanks for listening. And so long, everybody. Bye.
Winner Take All has been a Mark Goodson, Bill Trotman production. Produced for television by Peter Arnell. Questions by Ted Mayer and Alan Walker. Directed by Frank Jacoby. Technical director, Cliff Ball. Miss James Downs by Sheila Lynn. This is Don Pardo reminding you to tune in again tomorrow at the same time to Winners.
You're a winner!
GSN.
What's My Line? Brought to you by Post Honeycomb. Now bite-sized, so it's crisper, crunchier, better than ever. New Post Honeycomb.